Let's meet the man responsible for making this dream a reality, the president and CEO of the Martin Luther King Memorial Foundation, my fraternity brother, Harry Johnson. Harry?
Good morning. Good morning.
Certainly glad to have you here on TV One.
I'm glad to be with both of you all.
Harry, it is a phenomenal day, of course. The original dedication was supposed to take place on August 28th. Of course, that was the anniversary of the I Have a Dream speech. But Hurricane Irene had a different attitude, and so it was postponed. Yeah. But today is October 16th, which is also the anniversary of the Million Man March.
Without question, Irene came, but Irene did not kill the dream. How often do you have an earthquake on one part of the week and a hurricane in the other? Something was not meant to happen, but we're glad we're here today to see the thousands who will come out and see the President of the United States formally dedicate this memorial.
This has been a tough, tough process, obviously, trying to raise $120 million, dealing with the Park Service and dealing with commissions and dealing with all of the plans and everything. So give our audience just a sense of how significant and huge this task was.
Without question, I mean, to build a memorial anywhere in D.C., you have to report to three different commissions. Takes a time span of 20 years. We did in about 28 years. FDR took 45 years from concept to completion. So we've been ahead of the curve, but we tried to do everything right to put the right memorial, the right team together in terms of what it was going to look like, who was going to build it, how it was conceived, and I think we've done that.
Since I'm surrounded by alphas here.
Well, that's the way it's supposed to be.
Let's talk about what this means to a fraternity like Alpha and the history and the fact that the Alpha was the first black fraternity. Yeah. And this must be very significant for the history of this great fraternity.
Joe, without question, I mean, to say that the first African-American fraternity founded in 1906, conceived the idea to build a memorial of Dr. King, it's just unbelievable. I don't think we believed we could do it. We would go to conventions, and Roland knows this, every year, we're going to build a memorial of Dr. King. Yeah, right. Here's $20, leave me alone. But then when it got pushed through Congress and we got the land, then the determination set out and said we could do this. I believe in the minds of those five guys who thought we should do it. Let's raise $1 million and do this. $120 million project.
There is a joke going around that there goes the neighborhood. you've got Lincoln right on one side. You've got Martin Luther King Jr. looking at Jefferson on the other. Washington's down the way. And, of course, if we look south towards Virginia or west a little bit, Robert E. Lee's mansion.
I'm sure he's saying, what in the world is going on?
Well, I think what he's going to say, location, 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 to put Dr. King here. At first, they actually wanted to put us in Southeast D.C. in front of RFK Stadium. And we said, no, Dr. King deserves to be in the pantheon with everyone else. He changed not just this country, but indeed the world.
Absolutely.
He needs to be right there in the middle.
Harry, first of all, this is a 4-acre setting here. And so for the folks at home who decide to come here, what else is here? You got a bookstore. What will they see when they come here?
What they will see, they will walk through what we call the Mountain of Despair. Two large boulders of granite.
Right.
Walk through the plaza area, crescent-shaped wall, 14 quotations of Dr. King on those walls, and then walk on see Dr. King on a 30-foot-tall piece of stone called the Stone of Hope.
All right, it is absolutely phenomenal. Harry, we certainly appreciate it, man. Great,
you.
Great work. We still got a little money to raise, right?
$3 million.
$3 million, so
oh,
they want to
well,
give.
Roland got that. He'll take care of that.
So anybody at home who want to give, where do they go?
They go to 1-800-4-THE-DREAM, 1-800-4-THE-DREAM.
All right then, Harry Johnson, we appreciate
Thank
it.
Thank you so much. We appreciate you all.